Kuja, Tumbe Kuja, Kumi Bakuja, Tumbe Kuja, Tumbe Kuja,
Tumbe Kuja, Kumi Ba, Tumbe Kuja, Kumi Ba, Tumbe Kuja, Kumi Ba, Tumbe Kuja,
Tumbe Kuja,
Tumbe Kuja, Kumi Ba, Tumbe Kuja, Kumi Ba, Tumbe Kuja, Kumi Ba, Tumbe Kuja, In Bani,
good way of fear,
In Bani, In Bani,
tell the world where
we have come to see. In Bani, lift
voice on high.
In Bani,
let fill the sky.
In Bani,
shout aloud that
we have come to see. Tumbe Kuja Kusi, Tumbe Kuja Kusi, Tumbe Kuja Kusi, Tumbe Kuja, Tumbe Kuja Kusi, Tumbe Kuja Kusi, Tumbe Kuja Kusi, Tumbe Kuja Kusi, Tumbe Symphony,
symphony,
we have come to praise. Symphony, 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 we have come to praise.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Alleluia,
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 alleluia.
Today. That was the wonderful Tumbe Kuja Kuimba by Lynn Zettelmoyer. I think I'm remembering the name correctly. The next piece is one of my favorites. It's Psalm 150, which is a setting of Psalm 150 out of the Songbook of the Bible by the wonderful Southern American composer Hernani Aguiar. next piece that we're going to sing to you today is called The Road Not Taken, which is a setting of a very famous poem by Robert Frost, by the same name that you are probably familiar with. And it's set by the composer Randall Thompson. Randall Thompson is a wonderful American composer. He's been dead for a number of years, but when he wrote this piece, he actually set a group of 7 different poems by Robert Frost, and so this is the first movement of a larger piece called Frostiana. At the time that Randall Thompson composed this piece, he was the only composer who had been granted permission to set the poetry of Robert Frost. So at the time that it was written, it was a very special composition because these words had not been heard before set to music. So here's The Road Not Taken from Frostiana.
Thank you.
So much. The next two pieces, as we have with this piece sort of descended into the darkness of night, and the next two pieces are both lullabies. The first one is called Dorme Dorme, and it is actually a folk song. It's a Sephardic Jewish folk song. This is a Jewish community in Spain, and the language that you're going to hear the choir singing in is a language called Ladino, which is kind of a Hebrew-infused Spanish that I was not familiar with until we learned this piece. But it's quite a lovely song. And then it's followed up by the Seal Lullaby, which is a setting of a poem by Rudyard Kipling, who of course wrote the famous The Jungle Book. So the Seal Lullaby is sung from the vantage point of a mother seal singing to her baby seal. It's got one of my favorite bits of language in it, Weary Wee Flipperling, which I think is just a delightful turn of phrase. So, your babies as flipperlings, right? And the prayer that the mother seal sort of has for safety and comfort for the baby, right? Avoiding sharks and the other kinds of threats and hazards that seals have to deal with. Of course, it's metaphorical. But I hope you enjoy Dorme Dorme and the Seal Lullaby.
Thank you.
of time from all those nasty dark thoughts kind of come at me, or worries or anxieties, right? Did I pay that credit card bill? Who's going to take kids to school tomorrow? Or whatever, right? And I find that sometimes, you know, even if we're not feeling it, we might say a prayer. This next piece is basically a prayer. It's called Requiem. You might know that word. Requiem comes from the title of the Catholic service for the dead, basically a Catholic funeral service would be a requiem. This is not really a Catholic funeral service. It's just a short minute, 4 minute song, but it evokes some of those feelings of a prayer and, you know, longing for comfort. This arrangement is dedicated to victims of natural disaster, and some of the text in the song also reflects that kind of spirit in the song. So, Requiem. sometimes in the darkest times in our life, all we have left maybe is faith. And so I think this next piece is a beautiful testament to that. The words to I Believe are very short and simple. Right, the first verse is, I believe in the sun, even when I can't, even when it's not shining. I believe in love, even when I don't feel it. And finally, I believe in God, even when God is silent. And these words were found inscribed on the walls of a concentration camp in Nazi Germany. So very, very powerful words, and I think a testament to the strength of the human spirit in even the darkest of times, I believe.
I believe in the sun.
We're not going to sing it that way for you right now, though, so hope you enjoy our choral version of What a Wonderful World. Song. into what you are going to hear. So this is an arrangement of a original gospel song called His Eyes on the Sparrow, and it's, I think you'll agree, a really fun, energetic, upbeat number, and it's, you know, I think just that little bit of extra comfort, right? Sort of got someone watching out for us. Right? His eyes on the sparrow, and I know he's watching me. Especially a large class that is graduating and moving on to bigger and better things. And so I'm always sad to see them go. You know, I love them and I love seeing them twice a week for 4 years or 3.5 years, as the case may be. I'm graduating in December. And then they go. And it's, you know, happy for them, but sad for me and sad to not get to see them anymore. This class is the class that started in fall of 2019, and we all know what happened in March of 2020. So this is like our first COVID class that is graduating. So I'd love to acknowledge them. All right, so graduating this year is Dustin Huffer, give a wave, and Nash Cooney, and Darius Serginovic, and Bailey Sampson. Peyton Sparks, Blake Williams, and Kelsey Flowers, who graduated in 2022 in December, but also started in that same graduating class, and they are here on stage. So welcome back, Kelsey, and so glad you could join us for Homeward Bound. So again, thank you all so much for coming out to hear the Trine University Choir sing today. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your Saturday, and thank you so much for coming.